Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus...
Welcome everybody to Bishop Connolly High School to start up today's NJCAA Region 21 matchup between the Bristol Community College Bayhawks and the Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs. The Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs return this year as the region, as last year's Region 21 champions. And who do they beat? They beat the Bristol Community College Bayhawks last year in Springfield to win the Region 21 championship. Hi, I'm David Cardozo. Alongside me is the one, the only, Lucy Cabral on the fancy camera work. All right, if you're just joining us, Lucy Cabral just did an excellent, beautiful rendition of the Star Spangled Banner as we're 1 minute into this one at the line right now, Marcus McCarthy. Misses the first free throw. We're tied 2-2. Second free throw made by McCarthy. Bulldogs with the basketball. Bulldogs are in red. Bristol Community College in their white jerseys, their white home jerseys with the green trimming. BCC coached by eighth-year coach Rob Delalu. McCarthy going the other way. Number 23, Marcus McCarthy out there with the basketball, crossing over. Back out, Daniel Mendes. Armani Baker into the lane, rolls it up, and will step up to the free throw line. Again, these two teams faced each other last year in the postseason in the MACAC state championships that were hosted by Bunker Hill last year. Bunker Hill came out victorious in that one, and then those teams faced off in the following week in Springfield Technical for a chance to go to the national tournament in New York, in upstate New York, for the national tournament. And Bunker Hill came away with that victory. Ross. Stepping up to the free throw, number 11 for the Bulldogs. If you were watching earlier, if you watched the previous game, the Lady Bayhawks came out on top today against the Lady Bulldogs. Bristol Community College coming up with a 100-30 victory. Bayhawks move to 6-9 on the season. Here comes Marcus McCarthy. McCarthy, ooh, nice dribble move. Dirty to Armani Baker on the baseline. I think he got that partially blocked. Number one, Mendes, no good. Another offensive rebound. And that ball is going to go out of bounds. Here. for BCC number three. Dumps it into Armani Baker. Baker can't get it to go. Finally, the Bulldogs with a rebound. Oh, underneath. Bulldogs with some big eyes. 4-3. Bulldogs trying to trap. Here's Marcus McCarthy. McCarthy crossing over. Bulldogs bench energized. Nice defensive play. Cross court pass. Spinning in the lane. Oh, nice. Armani Baker bringing the ball up the court for the Bayhawks. A lot of intensity in this one. And it's early. Gonna be steps. Number five, Holloway, gonna come in. Checking the ball game for the first time today. 16:07. 4 minutes, nearly 4 minutes have elapsed. It's only 4-3. Bulldogs long and lean. Definitely bigger than the Bayhawks. 3-point shot, it's good. Nothing but net. And the Bulldogs have the early lead, 7-3. Mendez in the corner for three, good. Boy, do they need that. BCC's had some lapses the last two times up the court on the offensive end. Mendez stops that. That three-point shot is hoisted and good. Just like that, it's a three-point parade. 10-5. This is a fast-paced game, yes. All right, 15-13 to play. Here in the first half, 10-5, the Bulldogs have got out to an early lead on. Rob Del Lue just laid into his team as I was walking by the bench. Hopefully that's a little kick in the butt that they need to get going here. BCC, usually a pretty solid defensive team. Marcus McCarthy with the basketball. Bulldogs in their 2-3 zone. Cross court to Mendez. Mendez loses the basketball. Bulldogs with a fast break. I'm not sure what happened there. Shot clock going off for no reason. Bulldogs in that furious trap. Not having no numbers is going to be a foul. Foul's going to be on number 11, Mike Richardson. Pass intercepted by Mendez. Boy, this one has been off the hook so far. Different pace in the women's game earlier, that's for sure. Mendez deep from three, no good. Top of the key, no good. Ball tipped up. Players jump in there like jumping jacks. Bunker Hill comes into this contest 8-2, 6-2 in region 21. The three-pointer way off. Rebound, putback is good by number 11, Mike Richardson. Francois missed it, he was way off. McCarthy gets it inside, gives it to Baker where he likes it, and he'll score it. BCC won the first contest between these two teams this year. Cross-court pass. Bulldogs are going to turn the ball over. Looks like a traveling violation. Number 20, Charles Tevin checking in for number 22, Taris Wilson Jr. McCarthy calling the play out. BCC in that, Bulldogs in that 2-3 zone. Here's McCarthy. Mendez, 10 on the shot clock. Bulldogs playing tenacious defense. Going to his left, puts it up off the glass. Marcus McCarthy for two. We're just getting warmed up here. 3-point shot number 5, it's good. Swish. 17-11. Mendez pushing the ball back the other way. Mendez back out. Juan Espanol gets it. Juan Espanol, freshman from Providence, Rhode Island, making his debut here in the second half of the season. Oh, he gets it inside number 20. Charles Tevin misses the easy bunny underneath. I swear this first half has been a flash. It's been a whirlwind. You could tell that this game has a little bit more ante than the other ones. As these two teams are the two favorites to come out of Region 21, they'll be battling out again for sure. BCC already winning on Bunker Hill's home court. Bunker Hill trying to return the favor. BCC was a 93-61 winner back on November 22nd. 93-61. Bunker Hill has a lead, 17-13. And this is BCC's first game after the Christmas break. So they've been out of action since December 15th. That was a 94-57 rout against Roxbury. So BCC comes into today on an 8-game win streak. Their last loss was against CCRI on November 10th, a game in which they lost 79-67. Since then, they've won 8 in a row. BCC's 9-2, 9-1 in the conference. As I said earlier, Bunker Hill is 8-2. They're 6-2, so they're a game back in the loss column. with BCC. So this game would bring, this game could tie Bunker Hill with BCC in the loss column in Region 21. It's David Cardoza, along with the fancy camera work of Lucy Cabral here, also who also sang the national anthem with a beautiful rendition earlier. Here come the Bulldogs, driving towards the lane, strong, and drops it. Dropping it home as number four with a strong move, France Francois, who was part of last year's Region 21 championship team. Sophomore returning for another year of Bunker Hill. Actually, France Francois is the only player returning from last year's team on this roster. And he completing the three-point play is Francois. Armani Baker coming up and lays it in. Oh, laying it up and in, number 35. Anselm Edejbi. Both teams are loaded. Both teams are very deep, and very athletic. And they're going to call a foul away from the ball. It's going to be on number 20. They're going to call that one on number 21. Another new player for BCC. Three-point shot. He has a weird release, but it goes in. Zachary Guerrero, a sophomore, got that weird, like, Bill Cartwright release. But he's hung up a couple of those here in the first half. Baker being guarded on the perimeter. Drives to his left. Baseline. And they're going to call. Looks like they're going to call up and down. It's going to be Bulldogs basketball. Coming out of the game is number four. France Francois. Coming into the game is Jokari Trueheart, another sophomore. Swinging it into the corner. Trueheart gets it to go. Trifecta by Jokari Trueheart, sophomore. He just checked into the game for the Bulldogs. 28-15. Bulldogs now matching up man to man. Taken away by Guerrero. Took the ball away from McCarthy. Swinging it around the perimeter. Bulldogs, three-pointer. It's good. It's a three-point barrage. And the Bulldogs are hyped. Coming up to the river, they have a 16-point lead. Timeout. Timeout. Rob Zellou and the Bayhawks, they're going to need to get it together. So we'll keep it here. So both the teams, you can tell, you can sense there's just something a little bit extra in this gym tonight. Both these teams fighting it out tooth and nail as we begin the second half of the season after the Christmas break. And the Bayhawks are currently in first place in Region 21. They, like I said, the Bayhawks finished runner-up in the 2016 Region 21 tournament to these Bulldogs. And you can definitely see what's up on the horizon. Come late February, early March, these two teams could be in the same spot. This year, the national championship's in Minnesota. And that's what it's all about right now. These two teams evenly matched. Both athletic teams, both deep teams. Both got coaches with a long tenure, with a history of winning. Bulldogs playing tight man-to-man. Baker back out to McCarthy. McCarthy looking to drive. Jumps up. Jumper is good. McCarthy with the jumper in the lane gets it to fall, 31-17. Cross-court pass. Bulldogs with crisp movement around the perimeter. Oh, nice pass inside. No good, though. Here come the Bayhawks. The other way, McCarthy loses control of it. And I believe he was fouled. One thing I remember last year from last year's regional tournament and state tournament, yeah, the Bulldogs have some multi fans. BCC needs to shut them up in their own gym tonight. McCarthy, second free throw. Misses both free throws. Yep. That ball was rebounded by Adige. 24 on the court right now for your Bayhawks, number 23, Marcus McCarthy. Number one in the backcourt with him is Dan Mendes. In the front court, number 24, Armani Baker. Also number three, Juan Espinal. And Luis Rosario, three-pointer is good. 34-17. That was number five, who's not on my roster. McCarthy, back out. Espinal for three, off the mark. Rebounded by Trueheart, pushing it up court furiously. Oh, deflected, nice rebound, nice play by McCarthy. Out to Mendes. Can't lay it in. Back the other way. Trueheart off the glass, going to his right, tipped in by Adejbe. Anselm Adejbe there to clean up the scraps. The sophomore, number 35, taps it in. McCarthy with the miss, tip back up. Here's Baker. Baker taking it strong to the hole. Bulldogs and Bulldog fans want a charge there. Desby, good hustle, good job to get in front of Baker. Just didn't have his feet, just didn't have the proper position. And Baker's gonna get to the line for two. Monty Baker, returning sophomore. Was on a Bayhawks team last year that finished the regular season, winning their last 10 games. Bayhawks in a similar streak right now. Like I said, winners of their last eight. Monty Baker leads the team in rebounding with 11 rebounds per game. Also leads the team in points per game with 16.2. Stolen by the Bayhawks. Here's McCarthy. Bounce pass. to Rosario. He's not going to be able to catch up with it. McCarthy with the no-look pass just threw it out of the reach of Luis Rosario. Mendez. Nice reverse lay-in by number 5 for the Bulldogs, 38-17. Coming up on 7.5 minutes to play in the first half. Oh, nice pass. Nice pass to Rosario underneath by number 21, today's mystery player, apparently. Rosario on the wing to McCarthy. Three-pointer, 2-1, good. 2-1 equals three. 38-22. And the Bayhawks gonna try to inch their way back into this one. And there's a timeout on the floor by the Bulldogs. It's like making my head.
Yeah, I'm spinning.
Making my head spin, yeah. The intensity level too. Yeah. Oh yeah. 38-22. Right now the Bayhawks trail the Bulldogs. Bulldogs trying to come into Bishop Conley High School, the home of the Bristol Community College Bayhawks, and trying to end an 8-game win streak that the Bayhawks are on right now. They dump it back out for three. It's good. Another 3-point, this time by Jannard Jones. Double J, the freshman. 41-22. Driving in the lane, no good. Bulldogs all over the boards too and getting to all the loose balls. Nice stutter step to his left. Mike Richardson misses. And they're gonna call a travel, I believe, on Luis Rosario, number 20. And beat the Bayhawks turn the ball over. Number 22, Taris Wilson, Jr. coming into the game. He's going to inbound for the Bulldogs. Here's a three. It's good. There is no answer. Jannard Jones, double J for three. And the Bayhawks getting on the verge of getting embarrassed in their own gym right now. They're gonna prevent that. Oh, nice pass by McCarthy. Baker misses the jam, but then they're gonna say he's fouled by Mike Richardson. Baker will go to the line for two. Baker missing the jam, unfortunately. And he'll miss the first free throw. As I was saying, Amani Baker averaging a double-double. Averaging 16.2 points a game. He's ninth, that puts him ninth in the region. Ninth in region 21 to go along with those 11 boards per game. He's been a big money player. Second year starter for Rob Dell Luce Bayhawks as the BCC needs to chip away at this lead the Bulldogs have accumulated. 3-point shot, true heart. Wow, I've never seen anything like this in a long time. True heart gets it to drop. Mendez. And they're gonna call a foul on Bunker Hill. Bunker Hill has 17 fouls. That's going to put the Bayhawks at the line. 47 to 23. Mendes drops both. 47 to 25 now. Francois, the jumper from the elbow is good. There's Luis Rosario. I'm sorry, Marcus McCarthy driving all the way to the basket and in. Marcus McCarthy has been a welcome addition as he started this year on Rob Del Lue's Bayhawks team as a starter at the beginning of the year, and then he disappeared for all the reasons we don't know. But towards the latter part of the first half of the season, Marcus McCarthy made his triumphant return, and he's been damn good, to say the least. He just deepens his roster. Francois. He's going to get fouled. They're going to call that foul on number 14. That's Armani Baker. That's his first. And the team sixth. One more, and the Bulldogs will be in the bonus. Nice spin move in the lane. The jumper, no good. Rebounded by the Bayhawks, that's Dan Mendes. Mendes stops at the line, no good. At the elbow, missed it. Francois, nice bounce pass. Off the glass, slapping backboard. Number 14, Andrew William, a sophomore. Bulldogs have about 10 players on the bench. They have such a deep team. Contrary to the women's team, who played with four players today. What a contrast that is. I mean, 15 guys. The Bayhawks aren't exactly shorthanded themselves. They have a deep roster as well. Bulldogs just coming in with more intensity today. More fight and more intensity, that's for sure. It almost feels like a Bunker Hill home game right now. That's the way this game feels right now. Bunker Hill has all the momentum. Their bench is louder. They seem like they're more into the game. Bayhawks just going through the motions right now. Bunker Hill fans more into it. You can't shoot. They're louder. Their voices are being heard. Bayhawks need a little lift. Nice fake by Mendes going to his left and then putting it up with the right. Rebounded by Francois as he missed a layup. Great pointer, Trueheart. Finally, Bunker Hill with a miss. Length of the court, intercepted. Trueheart doing a good job of playing free safety back there. Trueheart. Back up to three, Janari Jones. And they're gonna call a foul on Dan Mendes. BCC giving away a lot of size right now. Or maybe I shouldn't say that. That free throw made by Jannard Jones. Because BCC is not really getting beat on the inside. They're getting beat from the long range. Free throw missed. Espinal with the rebound, and I believe he got fouled. Both teams are in the bonus. The Bayhawks are now in the double bonus as the Bulldogs get their 10th. The Bulldogs get their 10th foul now. Juan Espinal was not on the Bayhawks roster, the BCC roster, in the first half of the season. This is his first game. Misses the second free throw. And they're going to call Armani Baker with a push. They're going to call a foul on him. Bulldogs are in the bonus. It's a one-on-one situation. But as I was saying, Juan Espinal, number 3, freshman forward from Providence, Rhode Island, making his debut. And he's been all up in the mix. He looks to be a big part of this Bayhawks team going forward. An already deep team. Rob Del Lue has a couple more pieces that he has. Both free throws missed. So lofted in. McCarthy lofts it in to Baker, trying to go up strong. And he gets the foul. Baker does a lot of damage down there. Even though I think he's a little bit undersized. I always say this, but he's probably like 6'1", 6'2". But he plays a lot bigger than what he is. But he usually gets to the free throw line. Has a strong move on the baseline. We've seen it time and time again. He's got great athletic ability. Great ups. And he's the leader on this team. Quiet leader as far as I'm concerned. First free throw made by Baker. Baker's going to need to do a lot of cooking, a lot of baking. I'm going to have to heat this place up. In the second half, that's for sure. They need to cut it. They need to get this lead to around 15 or under before the first half ends. Try to creep up, try to set themselves up for success in the second half. This game feels like a playoff game. This feels like a tournament game right now. But the Bulldogs with a huge lead. Cross court pass. Francois, nice dish on the give and go. Not a give and go. Nice dish though. And going to the line is going to be Taris Wilson Jr. Actually, no. Not sure what they called there. So it's going to be a turnover though. Bunker Hill lost it out of bounds, I guess. I thought they called a foul. Nothing doing. Bayhawks with the basketball. That's good for them. Bulldogs do a loading, but they can do a great job switching. Jumper by Mendez off the glass and in. That's the guy that needs to heat up for the Bayhawks to get back into this. More free throws. Both teams in the double bonus now. That foul is going to be on number 23, Marcus McCarthy. That's his first foul. Number 1 for the Bulldogs misses the first free throw. Look looking to make this a 20-point lead. Missed it. The hustle and the putback. The rebound and the putback, they're going to count it. They do count it. Terrace Wilson swarming in. No Bayhawks player boxed him out, put a body on him or anything. He came out of nowhere. For the offensive rebound, timed it just perfectly. What an athletic maneuver. And now looking for the three-point play that could give the Bulldogs a 22-point lead. Missed it. They get the ball back, though. And it's going to stay right here. Again, BCC not boxing out during the free throws. Zachary Coteau out to Francois. Full shot clock. And they're going to call a push. They're going to call a push away from the basketball. Offensive foul, it's going to be on Terrace Wilson Jr. Number 22 has two, with 2:22 left to play. So number 22 has two fouls, and there's 2:22 to play. Awesome. Make a wish. McCarthy with the floater in the lane is good. No one came up and challenged him. Got in the lane and put up that little floater. Gets it to fall. BCC in zone. Three-pointer, number 20, it's good. Another three-pointer, this time by Charles Tevin. Oh, all alone. Good job by McCarthy to find Espinal hanging out around the basket. 57-37. Oh, nice pass. Nice pass. Johnny Hilaire with a drop in. Another steal by Francois, who lays it in. Bunker Hill scoring at an alarming rate. Mendez takes the three, dribbles in, takes the jumper, no good. Oh my goodness. Count it. Number one. It feels like a whole new season. These two teams who faced each other back in November, and BCC came out on top 93-61. This whole going back from way back then, it's gone the other way. Baker comes up to get it. Wow. They're going to call a foul there. That foul is going to be on number four. That foul is going to be called on number four. Armani Baker went into the lane, a little bit out of control, but he got hacked nonetheless. Baker takes the first free throw. BCC needs to come out with more tenacity, more intensity in the second half, because this game has been a sleeper for them. They sleepwalked through this first half, in my opinion. The Bulldogs, that's not my opinion, it's a fact. Both free throws made by Armani Baker. The Bulldogs have just been, they've been playing fast and furious. Not only have they been playing fast and furious, but they've been executing at an alarming rate. Number 12, Zachary Coteau. I mean, they're driving right to the basket. Full head of steam. They're taking it right to the rack. lot of guys have the ability to create their own shot and take it to the rack, and then, I mean, that hasn't even been the story. The story has been their outside shooting. Ryan Stopka will come in for Espinel with 48.2 seconds to go in the first half. Zachary Gattaro. High arcing shot. Drops it home for the second free throw, 66-39. Last seconds of the first half. Ooh, going for the steal. Oh, nice pass by McCarthy to get it inside to Rosario. Couldn't get it to fall. Going back the other way. Powering it up, number 23. Johnny Hilaire with another basket. And the Bulldogs are running the Bayhawks out of the gym right now. I think Mendez was fouled. Mendez definitely fouled. He's going to go to the line. Foul on number one. Bunker Hill playing well. I mean, for certain, to say the least. 68-39, 13 seconds left to play in the first half. If you're Coach Rob Del Lue, I'm not sure what you say to your team. But that's why I'm not the coach. 68-40. Going into the lane, putting up off the glass and in. Off the window, number one. That ball blocked by the divider. And at the first half, merciful, comes to an end. 70-40, 70 points scored in the first half by the Bulldogs. They've come in here ahead of steam. We'll see if BCC can climb back into this one and make this one a contest. Like I said, 70-40 here at the end of the first half. It's David Cardoza and Lucy Cabral here from Bishop Connolly High School. We'll be right back with second half action after this. All right, I want to welcome everybody back to Bishop Connolly High School here in good old Fall River, Massachusetts, where the Bristol Community College Bayhawks trail the visiting Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs 70-40 right here at the half. The story has been the outside shooting of Bunker Hill. They've been draining threes left and right. They've had an unbelievable first half, scoring 70 points, obviously. And it's been a little bit of everybody. Brenner, number five, well, he's led all scorers along with Zachary Gattaro, a sophomore. They both have 11. Shannar Jones sank a couple threes in the first half for Bunker Hill. He has 7. France Francois, returning sophomore, he has 9. So those guys all contributing for BCC. Very uncharacteristic first half, although they're missing a lot of their key guys, a lot of their key starters that are out for different reasons, disciplinary reasons, if you will, for lack of a better term. It's that time of the year where, you know, academic ineligibility is a big thing in all college programs. BCC scoring the first points of the second half. There's McCarthy for 3. And just like that, if they could keep up this pace, they could get back in this one, as we're not even a minute into it. 70-45. And you can already tell the intensity has turned up. BCC in man-to-man. Driving to the hole, nice dish. But can't get it to fall. Nice drive and dish. Bulldogs can't get it to fall. McCarthy crossing over, challenges number 23. Johnny Hilaire, who goes up against the rebound. Hey. Going back the other way. They're going to call in on number 11, Mike Richardson. And they're going to call him with a foul away from the ball. I'm sorry, it's going to be a number 12, Zachary Gattero, his first. Another three would be good. Rosario taking it all the way strong with his left. Tipped up. It's going to stay in BCC's favor. Again, BCC, this wasn't mentioned in the first half, but they are missing some key guys. Jose Mercado, Quincy Pope, Kevin Desire, all guys that are in the immediate rotation of Coach Rob Del Lue. Three guys that are starters, so they're missing those guys. A lot of time left in this one. Nice. Good dish. Oh, block. Number 22 at the line. Looked like a good block. Missing the first free throws is Terrace Wilson Jr. Wilson makes both free throws. Marcus McCarthy. McCarthy driving to his left. Back out to Espinel. The jumper is good. The jumper from near the elbow area around the free throw line. 71-47. Driving all the way to the rack. No one's stopping him as Francois. The lead is 26. McCarthy to Espinel, loses it briefly. Deep three by Mendez off the rim. And they're going to call a push. They're going to call it on number 23, Johnny Hilaire. Johnny Hilaire had 8 points in the first half. BCC needs some good possessions. They've had a couple good possessions to lead off this first half. They get inside to Baker. Lose control of it, tries to go up strong, and they're gonna call another foul, I think, on Hilaire going over the back. Armani Baker will step up to the line. You talk about BCC, you don't want to take away from the players that are on the court right now that are currently on the roster, but make sure you use. A couple more scores out there right now. You know, hopefully they'll get guys like Jose Mercado and Quincy Pope. Hopefully they get those guys back. Not sure of the status of those guys. But they're not here tonight. That's all that matters. Baker misses a second free throw. Still have a great team out there though. Just gotta get it going. Driving to his left, getting into the paint. And they're going to call a foul on number 20. It's Luis Rosario. Luis Rosario turns around and puts his hands up, like hoping that it wasn't a call on him. But it was. Number five looking to check in. Devontae Holloway. Devontae Holloway, a freshman from Salem, Mass. He'll come in for Rosario. Rosario getting a lot of playing time, a lot of run out there today. Number 23, Johnny Hilaire is like a man child out there. And I believe it's going to be a timeout on the floor. There is a timeout. The Bulldogs will call a timeout here in the early moments of the second half, 73-48. And this hasn't looked like the BCC team that we know. This is their first game here in the second half of the season. Hopefully they can get it together here and finish strong. Right now, this lead right now looks insurmountable, but we've seen strange things happen. Couple three-pointers, couple layups, couple defensive stops. But the way the Bulldogs have come in here, they really come here in here to play. I'd like to see the Bulldogs put a little, the Bayhawks put a little pressure on the Bulldogs. You know, start to get a little bit of that pressing action. Cause some turnovers, get some easy buckets. Free throw missed by number 23, Johnny Halea. Johnny misses both. Rebound by Holloway. Again, you need some quality possessions. Bulldogs match up man-man. Crossing over, getting into the paint, McCarthy. Nice dish to Baker. Misses it, stays with it and lays it in, drops it home. Baker is definitely good for that, creating second chance for himself. Sticking with his own shot and tapping his own shot back home. Good job by Baker with the hustle. Francois being got up by Holloway. That foul is going to be on the floor. We'll see who it's on. It's going to be on the Bayhawks. And they'll call it on Devontae Holloway. They're getting inside. Missed by Richardson. Tipped back out now, though. Driving, puts it up. No good. Baker up high for the rebound. Mendez going through the teeth of the defense. No good. Richardson on the break, the pass. Oh, what a block. What a block by Espinol. Baker up to Holloway. Lays it out the glass and in on the fast break. The lead is 21. Francois drives to the hole. And they foul him. That foul is going to be on number three, Juan Espinal, a freshman. Bayhawks coming out here with a little bit more energy. Playing much better on the defensive end, much more sound. Francois drains that, but BCC outscoring here in the early going. As Luis Rosario checks in for Juan Espinal, BCC on a 12-4 run here. Just stopped the first half, so playing much better. I think Rob Del Lue would just be better with a better concerted effort, better continuity, better energy. I think he would be pleased if his team can just get back into this one. Show some heart, show some fight. Not a good possession right there. That pass meant for Baker goes out of bounds. BCC now man-to-man, playing man-to-man the way they know how. Nice pass underneath. Nice pass from Johnny Hilaire. Finding underneath to Zachary Gattaro. Mendez from the wing, no good. Baker gets the rebound on the baseline, going strong. Gets his own rebound, no good. Can't get the second effort to fall, Armani Baker. To 52. BCC definitely playing with more energy and more determination in the second half. Going all the way to the hole is Francois, but he can't connect. Baker gets past Francois, kicks it in the corner. Mendez, that's his shot for three. Gets it. Boy, they needed that. That was big. Mendez likes that corner three. A lot of time left to go on this one. 76-55. What was a 30-point lead, still a 21-point lead, but it was a 30-point lead at the half. It was 70-40. Bunker Hill has only scored six. They've only had a couple field goals here in the first 6 minutes of the second half, so they've been going to the line a lot. Bulldogs already in. The thing that's scary, though, the Bulldogs already in the bonus now. BCC has 17 fouls. Mendez, little hesitation. And he's going to get fouled. I think that foul is going to be a number five. It is going to be a number five, Brenner. And Mendez will go to the line. Mendez sinks the first one. Mendez has a nice stroke. He's got a nice stroke from the free throw line. He leads the team with 81% from the free throw line. Again, the Bulldogs are second in Region 21. Who do they trail? They trail the Bayhawks. Not by a wide margin. Francois kicks it back out. 15 on the shot clock. Francois inside and gets it home. 78-57. Boy, the Bulldogs bench into it, screaming, chanting defense. They're into it. McCarthy gets it to the lane, scoops it up. No good. Baker with the rebound. Boy, he's so sound underneath there. Armani Baker with the offensive rebound, a putback. Going up for the pass there. They're going to call a foul. Devontae Holloway, good effort by him. He looked like a Patriot safety back there. Looked like he wanted to knock him out. Big game this Sunday, AFC Championship game. Patriots Steelers, 6:40 from Gillette. One more. Going into the lane, number 12, can't get it to fall. That miss was by Zachary Gattaro. Going the other way is Mendez. Mendez, busy like a bee. Humming and bumming, three-point shot, no. On the outlet pass, briefly had the numbers. Didn't need it, Charles Tevin drops it home. 80-59. Three-pointer by Mendez from the wing, no good. Loose ball on the floor. It's gonna be Brenner. Gonna be a 2-on-1. Oh, nice move there. Nice move in the open floor by Brenner, who lays it in. And BCC, who was climbing back into this one, BCC gets a couple baskets. I mean, Bunker Hill gets a couple baskets there to bring this back out to 23. You're watching the two top teams in Region 21, Division 3, Region 21. Two teams that met last year in the postseason. Two teams fighting it out right now in the middle of the season here. And it's going to be a dogfight, literally. The Bulldogs. Facing the Bulldogs, it's going to be a dogfight. As Rob Delu talks to his team right now, it's David Cardoz and Lucy Cabral here from Bishop Conley, right next to Bristol Community College. 12-18, this one is not over by any stretch of the imagination. Got to cut it to within 10. Got to cut it to within 10 around the 6-minute mark. These next 5 to 6 minutes are crucial for BCC. They want to get back into this one. McCarthy, nice crossover. Wow, they're going to call it out on the Bayhawks. Going to be Bulldogs basketball. Loose ball. Bayhawks coming away with it. Around the back pass from Mendez. Coming away with it somehow is Armani Baker. 82-61. BCC now playing with that sense of urgency that you need to see. Cross court pass inside. Get caught on the rim, but staying with it is number 35. Ansel Medesby. McCarthy kicks it in the corner. Rosario has an open three, drains it. Luis Rosario with the open three. Now it's a 20-point lead. Nice shot by Luis. Francois, there's a jumper. No good. Adesi missed the jumper. Francois comes away with it. Mendez, double pumps off the glass and in. Boy, how did he get that to go? Boy, they need him to step up right now. Danny Mendez, who was one of their top scorers earlier in the season. They need him, they get going. Three-pointer in the corner, off the side of the rim, tipped up. Oh, nice pass by Brenner. Brenner finding the cutting Gattaro, and he'll go to the line. Come the Bayhawks, 87-66. We're coming up on the 10-minute mark. If you're BCC, if you're going to make a run, you got to do it now. McCarthy dribbles and bibbles. Three-point shot. Step back. It's good. Boom. Eminem, McCarthy. That's a deep three by Brenner, and he sinks it. Oh, that's a dagger. Oh, just when you thought you were getting back into it, with McCarthy's step back three, Brenner comes from NBA range damn near and makes it. Boy, they've been making shots like that all game long, 90-69, 9:51 to play. And that was a big shot by Brenner, another three. And BCC takes a timeout. So BCC down by 21, but the coach of Bunker Hill Community College giving his team, laying into his team right now, and they're up 21. So. So 90-69. Again, it's had a tournament feel, it's had an intensity. You can cut the intensity with a knife in here, but at the same time, BCC just kind of outmanned. Yeah, they got a big team. They got a bunch of men over there for Bunker Hill. They got a big team, they got a strong team, but this is a team that BCC beat earlier in the year, but obviously this is a different team. And BCC is outmanned from a depth standpoint, where their bench isn't as long as it usually is. We talk about depth. You know, only how many guys are missing? A couple of guys, so only about eight players. Hopefully that changes. Here's Marcus McCarthy. Mendes keeping his pivot foot. Back out to Rosario. Only 10 on the shot clock. Needs something going to the hoop. Cross court pass. That's Rosario. That's his shot. No good. Rebounded by Baker. Takes it inside and lays it in. God, the ball just seems to always fall in his hands. That was a big possession there. From the top, no good. Brenner, boy, can he just drains threes out there effortlessly. Man, number five, Brenner. Can't do nothing about that, I guess. McCarthy for three, bang. Boy, it's been a three-point barrage by both teams now. Both teams making a lot of threes. You gotta put a hand in that guy's face. Boom! Eyeballs! Brenner for three. Boy, he is lighting. He is lighting the Bayhawks. Wow. He's lighting them up, man. Jumper by Pierre. Luis Rosario. Mendez going into the tree trunks. He'll go to the line for two. But Brenner just shooting ridiculously out there. I mean, he just shot that in the defender from one of the Bayhawks defenders. I mean, shot it with him draped all over him. Arm in his face. Time on the floor. Bayhawks calling a timeout with nearly 8 minutes to play. I said they needed to cut it down to within 10 by 6. Let's give it to 5. But they're down by 21 right now. So how do you cut that lead down to 10? You get to stop the outside shooting. I mean, the three-point shooting, they've been they've been shooting at an alarming rate right now. That's a lot of their points. I mean, they have a good sized team. They have a lot of, I wouldn't say a lot of their guys are tall, but they got some muscle inside there. They got guys that aren't afraid to go to the hole. They got a lot of guys that can jump. They're athletic. But they're shooting the hell out of the basketball. Not sure what the call on the court is. BCC is going to inbound underneath their own basket, though. Pierre, number 21, gets it to Mendez, uses his body, throws it up off the glass, no good. Here come the Bulldogs with the numbers. Jumper, Trueheart, no good. Rebounded by Brenner. Brenner. Back up to Chikari Trueheart, takes a three, bang! 2-1 equals three. Trifecta by Chikari Trueheart. Mendez, step back jumper, no good. Falls into the hands of who else? Armani Baker gets his own rebound. Boy, he's so unbelievable at that. On the offensive boards, missing his own shot and then getting the rebound. Great effort by that kid right there, Armani Baker, going to the free throw line again. But man, the Bayhawks down 24. Right now, time is one of the biggest roadblocks right now against BCC, and the fact that they got 10 team fouls. So Every foul that BCC commits from here going forward, the Bulldogs are going to be shooting two. So that's another roadblock. Baker misses the second free throw. Brenner pushing it on the fast break. Oh, my goodness, what a move there by Charles Tevin with a miss. Loose ball. Going back the other way. Number one, and they're going to call steps. Here's McCarthy. McCarthy driving to his left. Mendez getting into the lane, puts it up out the window and in. Defense! Boy, that Mendez, despite his height, he could get that ball in the lane, and he could score. Nice. Nice move there, getting to the hole of Charles Tevin with the floater. 101-78. Mendez thought about it, up fake, drives to his left, swoops up to the hoop. Going to stay right here. It's going to be off the Bulldogs. Corner, Brenner misses the short jumper, and then that gets off the glass. I believe Richardson tapped that in. 25-point lead. We're under 6 minutes to play. The effort by BCC. They've obviously turned up their intensity. They've turned it up a notch here in the second half, but it just hasn't been enough with the outside shooting for Bunker Hill. But they really have stepped their game up. I got to give them that. You can just tell it in their compete level, and the defense has been much, much better here in the second half. But still leaving guys a little bit with a little bit too much space, shooting from the outside, though. Trueheart bounces up. The shot is no good. Rebounded by Mendez. 103-80. Mendez zips up into the lane and lays it in. That looked easy. Oh, that's the defense they need on the three-pointer. That's how they need to defend the three-point line. Oh, he's wide open. Brenner, no good this time. Rebound by Richardson, lays it in. Gotta box him out. Brenner was wide open again, though. The kid, number 5. Oh, McCarthy thought about it. Baker with space in the lane. Swoop to the hoop. Down 21. Number 1, guarding number 1. Trying to get it inside. They dump it into Richardson. Goes to his left. Misses. Nice defense and the rebound there by Rosario. You're watching Bayhawks basketball, ladies and gentlemen, here on FRM Media. Getting down to the nitty gritty. Mendez in the corner for 3. Bounces out. On the break. And going to the line. Going to the line will be Sweets. Bayhawks near their season average as far as scoring points, but man, the Bulldogs have come in here and dropped 105 on them in their own building. But at the same time, here in the second half, the Bayhawks have outscored the Bulldogs. So it's been an evenly more of an evenly contested second half than it was the first half. It was 70-40 at the half. Rattling home both free throws. Number one, the guard, Sweets. Ryan Stopker in the game. And there's a timeout on the floor for the Bayhawks. 107-84, 3:53 to play. And it looks like, barring a miraculous turn of events, it looks like the Bayhawks' eight-game win streak is going to come to a close here today. Courtesy of these Bulldogs, who, you know, most likely these two teams will meet again. Bulldogs have won their last five games. Like I said, they sit closely behind the Bayhawks. The Bayhawks are on the top of the heap. Bayhawks high on their bird perch. But right under them is a dog, a dirty dog, the Bulldogs. They're right there. So these two teams, this might not be the last of it. Let's see who else is on the BCC schedule for Bristol Community College up next. They play Saturday against Springfield Community College at 3 p.m. Myself, Lucy Cabral, and Craig Salvador, the Portuguese Cowboy. Cowboy Craig, Cabral, and Cardoza is the C team, or really the A team. We're coming to you on Saturday, 3 p.m. That's when we'll be live. Be looking forward to your local listings. That's going to be a home game, and also next week, next Thursday, the Bayhawks will be playing Roxbury. That's an 8 p.m. game next Thursday night. Baker into the lane, gets the shot blocked by Mike Richardson. Richardson thought about three, goes to his left. That jumper, no good. Here's McCarthy. Telegraph that pass. Two on one now, laying it up easily, no good. Trueheart missed the layup. And now it's gonna be going back Bayhawks way. So after this game, four more games in the month of January. Four more games in the month of January, followed by five games in February. Three-pointer, no good by Mendes. They'll get inside, Richardson off the glass. Puts home the bunny, 109. 109 for the Bulldogs. Richardson having a quietly good second half. McCarthy, Stopka, jumper, no good. Francois from the wing, drains it. Another three. I want to see how many threes the Bulldogs. And a little showboat in there by Francois, and I guess much deserved because the Bulldogs, they put on a show. They really have. Gotta give credit where credit is due. Here's Baker, kicks it back out. Mendes underneath Espinal. Stopka, Ryan Stopka at two. Good to see that kid get in the game and score a bucket. He puts in a lot of great effort during practices, I know, during the week, and shows a lot of hustle, a lot of heart when he's in there. Second year player for the Bayhawks, Ryan Stopka. Good to see him get in the game, get some minutes and score a bucket, all his hard work. Coming out of the game is sophomore Francois, part of last year's Region 21 championship team. And a key member of this Bulldogs team, so he comes out of the game. 112-86. Espinal on the baseline finds Baker. If your coach Rob Del Lu. Where do you go now from here? Kicked it back out to Mendes. Tapped back out to McCarthy. And this game is academic. McCarthy for three. Coming off, no good. Man, this Bulldogs bench, they're noisy. They're a noisy group. The Bulldogs bench sounds like 20,000 fans. Sounds like the TD Garden. They really have been into it. They've really been vocal. As have their fans in this one. Like I said, it felt like a Bunker Hill home game. BCC fans need to step their game up. And the BCC girls, I like to see them get more into it, like the men do for them. They should be over here helping the men. They should be out there cheering the men on like the guys do when they're playing. Return the favor, girls. At the line, Ja'Kari Shewhart. Rains a free throw. Second free throw, good. Stopka, another one. Ooh. Couldn't get it to fall to the bottom. Getting it. They're going to call steps. I think they're going to call a travel. Not sure what they call there. Either way, BCC basketball. Mendes on the wing, tees it up. Three-pointer's good. A little bit too late. But BCC going to have to regroup. I'm sure they will. Hopefully they get a little bit more of their firepower back. Either way, they got to regroup and forget about this one. This one has been a slaughter. More steps. More steps there by number 10. That's going to be it. The clock is going to wind out. Wind down. That's it. 114-89. Bunker Hill comes in and ends the Bristol Community College Bayhawks 8-game winning streak on their home court here at Bishop Colony High School. So that's it. 114-89. The Bristol Community College Bayhawks dropped from 9-2 to 9-3. 9-2 in Region 21. The Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs are now 9-2. They are 7-2 in Region 21. One game. I'm sorry. They're tied in the loss column with Bristol Community College in Region 21. So those two teams are neck and neck, 1-2 respectively, both tied now, probably number one in the region. So anyways, for David Cardoza and Lucy Cabral, you have been watching Bristol Community College Bayhawks basketball. And that's it, 114-89, Bunker Hill Bulldogs. Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs are winners. So long and good night, everybody.